Here's one for you. I'll take the other side's argument, you know, to be fair. The United States, the beacon of democracy
She
worldwide,
says.
is not even a member of the ICC,
Oh,
right? I
okay.
mean, this is something that I asked. You have the ICC at one point wanting to investigate the behavior of US soldiers in Afghanistan. And the US said, stop it, you don't have jurisdiction. Our courts are working. The same argument that Senator Bato de la Rosa is making today. So the US said that our courts are working, we don't need you. By asking this, Senator Risa, are you saying that our courts aren't working? You don't trust our courts. That's actually convicted two presidents already.
I trust our courts, in principle, Karen. I do. Pero in terms of delivering justice, lalo na sa mga biktima ng EJ case, justice is very slow. At di ba may kasabihan mismo yung mga inhabitants ng judiciary or all lawyers, not just the latest justice. Tingnan lang natin sa wakas, pag-post ng bill ni former Senator Leila De Lima, siya mismo nagpaalala, she's one of many persons unjustly deprived of liberty, accused, convicted, and persecuted. Yung dalawa so far na tagumpay ng mga EJK family sa ating mga korte, mga pamilya ni Kian De Los Santos, mga pamilya at nina Kulot de Guzman at Carl Angelo, these are two of at least 6,000 up to 30,000 EJK victims. So napakakaunti pa. Kumbaga, mga pira-pirasong hustisya. And in this context, we as Filipinos, I think, could and should welcome international assistance through institutions like the ICC. At sa mga ibang bansa tulad ng Estados Unidos, ating kaalyado ngayon sa West Philippine Sea at sa buong maritime zone ng Pilipinas, we probably feel towards countries like the US who are not yet part of the ICC na magandang sa sarili nilang mga domestic processes, i-consider din nilang sumali dito para mas maging solid yung community of nations, community of shared values in terms of membership in these different institutions.
Now, the argument then, I'm going to raise another one is the ICC really effective? Will it make a difference? You have Putin right now. The ICC came out with a strong decision and he's still in power. So you may have to say, what's the point, right, Senator?
Ang punto niyan is precisely to show that the community of nations is a community of shared values at sa pamamagitan primarily ng ating political at diplomatic actions. So diplomacy and peaceful politics na nahabol ko yung bahagi nung interview mo kasama ni Iya Coronel Ferrer. The point is that the community of nations, the international community, nations with who are kindred spirits sa ganitong mga prinsipyo ng human rights at international humanitarian law can make a difference. Because halimbawa, kahit sa West Philippine Sea, sa Philippine Maritime Zones, a bigger coalition is a better coalition, I always say, vis-a-vis China. And the same for all nations when we act together on common issues. Kung mabagal man yung pagbabago ng domestic politics, ano na yan, proseso at desisyon ng bawat sambayanan. Pero malaking bagay when we, individual countries, feel the international community supporting us in our struggles.
Okay, two last questions. I hope you can answer this briefly. Isn't this also a question of politics? You have Vice President Sara Duterte, who's so popular and talks right now, is they're using the ICC to silence her, in effect, weaken her politically, right? I wouldn't say hold her hostage, that's a bit too extreme, but weaken her politically, that's one. So is this administration also using the ICC politically in that regard?
I don't
Will
know about the
it benefit them? Will it
administration.
benefit? Will it benefit President Marcos Jr. politically to rejoin the ICC?
Oh, well, it will benefit him as president of all of the Filipino people kasi dumadami sa atin ang nananawagan yan. The past 6-7 years since Duterte withdrew us from there. As for VP Sara, she's perfectly capable of weakening herself politically on her own. Palagay ko, ginagawa na niya yan sa sarili niya at this point in time. But she's seen, as far as the eye issue is concerned, matagal na itong ipinapanawagan ng mga mamamayan. Ever since Duterte withdrew us from the ICC and the Rome Statute, mula nung nagsimula yung unang EJK, humihingi na talaga ng hustisya ang mga pamilya nila dito sa Pilipinas at sa buong mundo.
Okay.
So this is more than those politics. It's really about justice and accountability.
Okay, speaking of accountability, but I'll give you 1 minute to answer this. I know it's not fair. The budget. All right. The Senate, this is a whole other program altogether, but the Senate already approved the budget. It's at 5.768 trillion pesos. Just holistically, do you have a main concern about this budget? I mean, you are in the minority, so I know you're one vote. You have specific issues. Majority controls the budget. But what is your biggest concern, if any, with the budget?
Two biggest concerns, confidential and intelligence funds, and we aim to bring this to the finish line when Malacanang signs the budget. And I'll actively participate in the BICAM for this. So bantay na bantay dyan sa Confi and Intel funds, away from, you know, contingent funds even of OP to augment Confi and Intel funds of civilian agencies na wala namang national defense and public safety mandate or expertise. And flesh out more yung spending ng ating budget para sa social protection. So, interest subsidy para sa pabahay sa mahirap, more personnel services ng Marawi Compensation Board at kahit sa special provisions lang, dagdag na compensation budget para sa mga biktima ng Marawi War. At syempre, mas maraming social protection doon sa Kalusu amendments in the Senate version para dito.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you for joining me today,
you,
Senator Risa Ontiveros. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.